right, is everybody here? Let's see here.
Roger.
Holy shit.
So, we got Rush, present. Hello, Rush? Nope.
He's here.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, Cake?
Yeah.
Monty?
Yee-hee.
Sanity Unknown? Okay, I saw you blink.
I think I seen him.
He is here.
Okay, Ro?
He's gonna have to turn.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see here. Tinner? Yeah.
Yep, Tinder's here.
He's deafened.
Hell yeah. And then Parabellum? Nope. Okay. Neely's here. No, I heard him. Custer, Broadsword, Juggernaut? Okay.
Nope.
Shadow?
Yeah, but I'll shoot him a quick message.
Okay. Juan and Judge. Okay. That's fucking. That's damn near everybody. And then Kessler, Ethan, Arby's, and Deathstalker. I assume you're all here.
Uh huh.
I'm going to go over quick rules here before we get started. Rules, please keep the tomfoolery to a minimum. But the basic outline, what we're going to do, we're going to go over some general tips and tricks for squad leading in Post Scriptum. It's not going to make you a genius. They're very basic maneuvers that we're going to try out. Kessler, Arby's, Ethan, and Shadow, make sure you got SL kits so you can follow along with some of the things we're talking about. Some of the basics we're going to go over, like your compass, map, keyboard binding, map marking, shit like that. So, all the squad leads in training, why don't you line up? So, everyone knows how to use their compass, right? Y is the button for it, unless if you have it bound to something else. With that compass, you also have headings. I'm sure you guys are aware, they're the smaller numbers underneath the direction. That's extremely crucial as a squad leader to make sure that both you and your squad know how to use that shit. Do you all you guys have your map bound to your M button, or do you have it something more clever? If you have a multi-button mouse, I highly recommend putting your map on there. You're going to be looking at it a lot, and it's much easier to access than reaching over to the M button there. Another thing is using the map. So who here knows how to actually use the damn map? And I'm talking grids.
Yep.
Judd.
Okay, for people that do not know, this is a really rough estimate, but if you look at your map and you zoom all the way in, that smallest square, that's about 33 meters, about, okay? The second largest one, that's about 100 meters. If you zoom out, there's a largest square, that's about 300 meters. Again, this is very rough, and depending on terrain, that can change, but it gives you a general idea of how to mark off and communicate things to people, especially in command chat. So if you're helping a mortar team, that's a great way just to get rounds out on the field, and then you can adjust from there with your spotting team. So, did that make sense to everybody?
Yep.
Okay, yes. Has everyone had experience with the marking system as an SL?
Yep.
Okay, some of the common ones, of course, move fast, rally, infantry marks. I don't know if you guys know, but you can actually put a direction on most of the marks. It's that same compass you would use to call in airstrikes. You just point it in the direction that you want people to know that they're coming. Everyone knows that SLs can build stuff, correct?
Yep.
Okay. Because a lot of SLs do not. And that...
well, not place, but... or not build, but place. Because they don't have a shovel.
Right,
but they can place defenses. As long as they have supplies next to them.
Do all you guys know how to do that?
Yeah.
Does anybody not know how?
For those who do not know how, it is T on your keyboard. So, you get damn near access to everything. The SLs can also put down fobs, and that's something that a lot of SLs do not know. You can put down fobs, but you need that supplies nearby. Typically, that's something handled by Logie, but if they're in a pinch, they might have to rely on you to put the fob down.
Or take it down.
Or take it down.
Yep.
Hell yeah.
Yes.
So, the last thing within basics that I want to let everyone know is volume management, okay? There are a lot of people that we play with in OSS that have not took the time to go through their volume menu and modify things so they can hear better. Naturally, PostScriptum is horseshit at what is loud and what should be louder, right? So one thing that I figured out is if you go into your sound settings, if you want to follow me along here, go over to audio. You'll see you have master, effects, UI, music, etc., right? I would recommend highly turning your effects volume down. That means when you're next to a tank and you're trying to give your squad orders, you can hear them. Turn your master volume up if you have to. As for command volume, local volume, and section volume, I usually have command volume at 100% and local and section at 200. Typically, in most pub matches, the command chat is being used the least. And as a squad leader, you'll have lots of people talking at the same time. You'll have command, local, section, and sometimes Discord. So you're going to want to be able to figure out who's telling you what. Sometimes it helps if they're at different volumes.
I would also add in that not everyone's headsets are with Sarge's is, so
exactly.
I would just test it out yourself and get to what where you're comfortable with sound settings. And I honestly, there's definitely games where you run into command comms being the loudest thing you've ever heard in your entire life, and it is the most annoying thing you've ever heard.
And constant.
We call that
and nonstop. Exactly. So that's gonna be that one's gonna be a major pain in your ass. It's just something you have to fight through. I personally keep command comms quiet.
Yep.
And too. Also, if you're not squad leading, I would keep your effect noises louder, especially if you're running like AT or you're being like a recon element for your squad or something. Because if you hear vehicles earlier than other people, you'll be helping out. So that's my opinion on that.
You know, I personally have a 7.1 style headset, so I keep mine a little bit louder than most people. But that also gives me the slight advantage of like, hey, there's possibly someone coming up from downstairs, or hey, there's sounds like there's someone upstairs. I could tell a good direction of where the shot's coming from.
But at the end of the day, all the audio settings is kind of like key bindings, whatever's comfortable for you.
Exactly. Yeah. The point is you can change them and you should, depending on what you're doing.
It makes squad leading a lot more effective if you actually take the time with audio and key bindings too.
Right. So that would wrap up the basic section. The next section is general tips and tricks for squad leading. So I'll just go down the list here, and if anybody has a question about any of them, just stop me and ask. The first thing I've realized in PostScriptum is the minute you start your match, you want to take command of your squad. You want to make sure they know they're going to have a squad leader that's going to be talking and giving them objectives. Because I guarantee you, within the first fucking 2 minutes, if you don't say a word, they're going to do whatever the fuck they want. They're not going to listen to you. And then you're going to be stuck with a fucking sandbag squad, and that sucks. So I encourage everyone to introduce themselves, be like, hey, I'm Sarge, we're going to take this objective, get them all riled up, whatever you got to do. Just make sure they know that you're going to be active.
Hype the boys up, guys.
Yep. Always make sure the squad assumes you have a plan, even if you fucking don't. You know, the longer they believe that you got it figured out, the longer they'll listen to you. I guarantee it. We've all had it. You have a guy that talks in the squad way too fucking much. A good thing to do is just set radio chatter expectations. You know, just say, hey, I want to have fun too, but I don't need a fucking play-by-play. If you went around the corner, you got shot, you need a medic, blah, blah, blah. Use local comms for that. Just encourage them to use local comms for that. So that way, any information coming over the squad comms, among all the other information you're getting, is important. Don't feel afraid to say clear comms. Be commanding about it. You know, they'll respect that. The next point I'm going to break up is super duper important. It is fire teams. If you can break up into two fire teams, you can be a much more effective squad. And that is exactly what we're going to be experimenting with today. How you want to arrange your fire teams is completely up to you. But I encourage, you know, keeping the AT in one and then the MG in another. You're going to want to make sure everyone understands their role. Make it clear to them that they're important. Those aren't just roles you just hop into. I always encourage my marksmen to scout ahead to wherever the squad is going. That makes them feel important, and it actually serves a legitimate purpose. You know, it's one man. They can scoot around a lot quicker. And you know what? Usually they can scout out to see if, hey, Lodgy's been building up the next objective. So now we know we can put an airstrike on it, right? MGs, I always encourage to stay to the back of the group in case if something happens, you know, they're there to hop down and provide covering fire.
The MG's job is not to go in to a building and clear it out. It's not really the medic's job either. They should be, like you said, farther back because they're kind of the support role in the squad.
Exactly. And you know what? If that Browning goes down or the MG42, you're in a lot shittier place than you were before, you know?
Radio men can often take the place of a sort of platoon sergeant, I've found. Like, if you trust your radio man, have him run the squad while you're talking to command. Have him get people going, get them going in the right place while you're figuring out what the plan.
That's exactly how I run it, too. So, it depending all on the squad that you have set up, if you definitely know the guys that you're working with, which most of us do know who we are, and we've worked with each other before, it gets easier as time goes on. Sure. Definitely squad leading, it can be a challenge. Don't feel like you like, hey, I'm gonna go do this right away and then kind of get cold feet in the middle of the situation. If you are unsure of yourself, it's okay. Like, sit in the squad with someone who you know has squad led before and learn from their mistakes. That's the best way of doing it.
Another big thing is when your squad starts taking casualties, just make sure they know where to spawn. Everyone spawn at the rally. Hey, everyone spawn at the MSP. Just give them clear, concise directions there. Did anybody else want to add anything to the fire teams?
I was going to say, if you split up the MG, make sure that he has a rifle.
Yep, so that's also, if you guys are looking at the dock, that's another point. It's to make sure your AT guy and your MG have a rifleman buddy.
Binos. Use binos.
Oh boy, yeah, I forgot a big one, actually.
With the binos, of course, radio man and medic both get binos. So
yes. You can mark things. Again, it's with that T button. That's how you mark things.
And also with the T stuff, like, don't be afraid while you're running around just to throw down a move fast where you want to go. Like, sometimes it's a little inaccurate because you're moving, but...
Yeah, but it gives them the idea.
It gives them a general idea, and yeah, and then if you use binos, you can use attack marks, you can use defend marks, you can do move fasts. Like, okay, let's use these pieces of cover to move up to this point.
The move fasts are like, they're really helpful for your kind of zombie players.
It's a cattle herder.
Move fast, yep, they'll just it's exactly a cattle herder. They'll just kind of go where you kind of place it. Yep. So.
There's actually a technique emerging right now. It's called the breadcrumb move fast marker method. And what it is you literally make a trail. I think you get a max of 2, so you'll have to average it out, but it works every time.
I have another one.
Go for it.
If you have a marksman and he notices either a FOB, MSP, Logitruck, and he gives you the coordinates, always place down like the correct placement for that coordinate. So then command lay down arty or send a squad to intercept.
So a great way to make sure that you're not putting inaccurate infantry or tank or whatever marks, don't use the red markers or the blue markers, because those are for that everyone can see those markers. Use the green markers because that's only seen in your squad. So you can drop that and be like, is that right? And you won't confuse the whole rest of the team.
Exactly.
Great idea.
And it's
multiple games where we've been playing and it's like, hey, there's a tank up ahead. And all of a sudden there's like 6 different tank icons pop up. And we're like, which one's the real one?
Exactly.
Right.
And like, If somebody in your squad is being like, oh, there's enemies over there, and you're like, well, I need a better description, give me a landmark and distance. This might sound like overwhelming information for like starting out squad leads, but like what I think it is base it off of the situation. Is like, don't be in the middle of a town where you got infantry surrounding you, basically, and be trying to put markers down and shit, trying to focus on the map. In that situation, lead the conflict, like be yes. in the shit. But if you're like, you just set a rally and you're trying to figure out where your squad's gonna go, then you focus on that stuff, because that stuff is essential and gets you less in the shit than you would be if you didn't. You know what I mean?
I know personally, like I said, when I squad lead, I don't like to have a lot of people lead in front of me, because it's me personally. Like I said, if I'm going to see something, I'm going to call it out so the rest of the squad knows it's there. So I personally like to take lead in front of my group that I'm leading. That's just my personal play preference.
All right, we're going to move on to the next point here. Keep this going.
Yep.
The next point is rallies. Just some general information here. You are able to refresh or place a rally from any radio man alive or dead, any other squad's rally, or command vehicle.
A fob.
Yep, a fob's another one.
You can use the enemy's fob and enemy radio men and enemy's...
Holy shit.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
Holy crap.
This is what you learn with 1600 hours.
Drop a rally down and let your sapper come in and blow it up.
Jesus, that's gold. Gold.
That is gold. I never knew that.
Tinner's got a gold mine of information. Man.
Yeah.
If you need to know anything about this game,
glad to have him here today. Thanks for coming, man. Another commonly unknown tactic is if you spawn on your rally and you need to refresh it, set a brand new one down. You'll get a longer timer on it, actually. It'll buy you just a little bit more time. There is strategies involved with rallies. For anybody that's played with me, I'm aggressive with my rallies. I get them usually in a safe-ish spot, as close to the point as I possibly can. And that's just my style. It seems to work in the sense of when you need to throw a lot of troops at it really quickly, as in... there's nobody on the point and you can quickly cap it, I can throw that rally and have my entire squad in there in a few seconds. You know, and they don't have to run very far. Some people like to be a lot more conservative with their rallies. It's all dependent on what you're doing. Yeah. I mean, obviously, if you're behind enemy lines, you finally flanked around after 20 minutes, you might want to be a little more precious with the rally. But... you know, when you need to throw troops at it, I usually get it pretty close. I'm sure a lot of people know this by now, but you can't put rallies within objectives. That's a pretty common knowledge thing there, but some people might not know that.
Also, the red zone doesn't affect that. You can place rallies in the red zone.
Good point. Yep.
Anywhere outside of a cap zone.
Always going hot.
Yep.
So usually when your rally goes hot, that just means there's enemies nearby. Depending on how well you have it hid, you might be able to wait it out. There's a common bug right now where it will come online again, or it won't go red, but it's either already destroyed or there's still an enemy nearby. Yeah, so just be aware of that bug.
Also, if you're going to spawn in somewhere and you saw it was hot and then immediately it kind of goes back to yellow, just be aware that if you spawn in, you might get shot immediately at spawn in, because some people like to do that. They'll find a rally, back off, let it spawn people in. They'll either throw a grenade in or they'll shoot people.
The range for rallies going hot, it's very small. It's within 30 meters. There's an enemy within that range when the rally.
This wraps up, unless there's anything else the instructors want to add, the briefing section of this training. The next one, we got four different scenarios that the Americans are going to try. Everyone on the German team, and I have these predetermined here, you'll just be cannon fodder. Play the game like normal if you can. Go easy on them. I'm going to say who the Allied team is, and everybody else that was not named, go to the German side, okay? So, Kessler, Arby's, Ethan, Shadow, you are going to be switching off after each exercise. Monty, Roe, Cake, Rush, you guys will be allies, okay? That makes sense?
Copy.
Yep. Here to be a basic bitch.
Alright, everyone else switch over to the German side.
Okay.
Okay, so Germans, I'm going to have you grab your MSPs and everyone hop in. All right, boys, they are getting ready to push you, so I guess get ready.
Push it in.
Oh, boy, this is fun to watch it play out.
Are they talking in Discord or are they talking in...
They're talking in I think in-game, but they can use the Discord. They're coming.
I said marksman and MG.
Honestly, how we're helping them the shooting air? Smoke.
I know. You guys do you. That's awesome, though.
Beautiful.
They have no idea.
I know. Don't use binoculars. I see you.
Okay, we've made...
I don't know how they saw him.
The mortar killed Neely and a couple.
I kind of want to let it play out.
It's not like they're being relaxed with it.
Yeah.
I could make him a lot.
Oh, shit.
It's nice. I
Are
like
we being so bad?
Let's see what happens. Let's see what happens.
Come up.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, it seems like
I'm just sitting here digging down a freaking mortar that's like taking.
Yeah! Hell yeah!
Okay.
Look at that. Beautiful.
I blew up.
I saw that. That was crazy.
Get your grenades out. We're gonna grenade volley right in front of you.
Oh.
Whatever you want. Three grenades ready.
Oh my god. So good.
One, two, three. As soon as those grenades are up, get up and charge. Let's go!
Do we know who Landon Red is?
He's one of our guys.
Doesn't have any tags on, so I don't know.
God! God! That was fantastic. Oh,
okay.
My God. Okay, they almost got you.
Like three left.
It's almost done. I almost got it. Great fucking work, boys. Great work.
Jeez, you guys fucking housed these.
You guys did nice. So well. All right, everyone, head back up to the American base. All right. So the next squad leader is going to be Arby's, okay? So Arby's, you're going to take over. Kessler wants you to promote him. And then look at the Google Doc. It is the White Christmas maneuver. So what you're going to be doing is you're going to have Fire Team 1 break off and do a fake flank. They're going to pop smoke, tricking the Germans into thinking you're going to push through the smoke while your other fire team is in a different flank, okay? While they're distracted with the smoke, your fire team will then engage the enemy in grenading distance. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that actually, without me knowing, falls into sort of what I had in mind.
But you are free. The floor is yours, Arby's. Go ahead.
Copy.
Oh boy, Custer. There they go.
The ammo box. Yeah, the ammo box.
Yeah, don't make the same mistake twice. But you did good.
Hey, don't get too close to that MSP or else they'll know you're flanking over here. Sorry, buddies.
All right.
Hello.
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 Are you guys actually playing Post Scriptum?
Yep. We're doing our training.
Alright. How long you got left, mate?
It's gonna be a little bit.
Alright. Hit us up, mate.
No problem. Apparently
okay, we have
not.
Too many MGs, Jesus.
Yeah, I'm talking about erratic fire here and there.
Wow. Oh, but please don't destroy that one Jeep to your left.
Aww.
I know you guys like destruction.
Alright.
Got me.
That was a good shot on me.
Make sure to use your smokes or whatever team you're designating to do smokes.
Who's leading this one, Sarge?
That would be Arby's.
Oh, Christ.
Ooh.
Oh.
What the fuck was that?
Jesus.
A little shit, that's who it was.
They know they're sappers, apparently.
There's the smoke. Is everyone down?
Nope.
No, still a couple up.
Two more.
Play dead. Everyone play dead.
Don't tell them that, Custer.
Allies are still up.
This is when you call on support on your position. Broken arrow.
Still, they're doing pretty well.
They are.
Ooh. True got wrecked by Monty.
Oof-ta.
That's it. I like that the MG is still up, even though the bunker's blown up. Not live. D-live.
Kill.
Alright, boys. How you doing?
Good.
How do you think that went?
Very good. Rifle grenades are very effective.
Yeah, I saw. I actually was right over your shoulder when you pumped that over. That was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Arby's.
I was harassing from the north. Yes.
How did you feel it went for you?
I mean, I feel like it pretty much went the way I thought it was. Probably could have had the fire team one hold off on firing closer. Might have kept them wide the first time.
Yeah.
As for that, MG had a really good position and it did have good distraction. Didn't have any issues getting up.
Yeah.
All right.
I agree.
So behind us.
They're going to be attacking.
A nice thing, too, is when I was taking shots of them from the north, their machine guns kept trying to hose me, so they weren't focusing on you.
Right.
Exactly. Also, they had, from what I've seen now standing in base, all their machine guns were aiming directly through that open.
Exactly. These operations, they just go how they go. The point was, and I'm sure you all understood, was to start the smoke screen before engaging, and then that's when you attack from the other flank, which you guys pretty much did. It just got a little messy because they spotted you, right, as you were moving down the hill. So my only critique is next time maybe make a little wider flank so they don't see you. The best element of surprise you can possibly get, you know. Because, I mean, they almost have 360 view except for their south, right? So just keep that in mind.
Yeah, and I think part of that is due to the fact that I was a little bit confused at the start where the actual point was.
Oh, gotcha.
The path that I had them taking was a little too close.
Gotcha. Okay.
I have something to say as well.
Go for it.
So, good job utilizing your sapper. I mean, obviously, getting rid of those two bunkers, it was a really good idea. And then also wrapping around, using your marksman as a viewpoint for where the enemy is.
Yeah,
I like that a lot.
Yeah.
So good job.
That was great.
Sapper is your best
friend.
That's
all me. That's all me, baby.
I can't really take the credit for the sapper because he picked that class and he did that without me having to tell him.
Roger.
Ooh, nice.
That's perfect. Well, at least it gives you an idea if you're ever in a similar trench situation, which we will be at the end of the game. So, does anybody have anything else to add, instructors?
Fantastic job. I mean, you guys are facing against people who have... I mean, Tenor has fucking 1,600 hours on this game. You guys are facing against him, and most of you guys bought this game literally 2 weeks ago, even a week ago probably. So, good job, and can't wait for obviously more on this round.
Okay, so moving on. Deathstalker, you're going to be squad leading this next one. Got it?
Top of that.
Okay, so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to break into two fire teams. If you're looking at the Google Doc, we're doing surprise, a defensive tactic one. So the point of this exercise is whatever fire team you want, Shadow, you're going to have them at a weak, easily evacuatable position, okay? And you're going to want to draw the enemy to that position. It's going to be your kill center. This one's going to be a little tough to pull off, but I think you can do it. Once you engage, that fire team is going to come back to the defendable area. The enemy is hopefully going to move in where they were and hit the mines, okay? And that's supposed to thin them out. It's going to kind of be in a kind of an offense defense, okay?
Okay.
Shit, you guys doing mortars?
Boy, you guys fucking put the hurt on him right away.
Jesus.
Hey, you guys are about to run up on Shadow. Don't kill him. You're about to run up on Shadow.
Well, don't tell him that.
Stick him.
Don't.
I'm in the war room, by the way.
Okay. Oh, you guys.
You guys are. Oh my god.
Just.
Shut.
Yeah, never mind.
God damn. Go to every channel.
Okay.
Oh my god, wow, you guys are killing
bastards.
Told you we needed only one life.
Shit. Oofed. God, you fucking assholes. Oh, you bastards. These poor guys.
Yeah, I was holding my button on accident.
Hold fire.
I know. I'm just letting them know I see it. Yeah, you guys better fucking crawl off that ridge.
Yes.
Live, Nice. Fucking A, boys. Alright, make sure you guys are somewhat making an advance on the point there.
We're dropping them farther up.
Keep it up, buddy. Oh, Judge. I saw that. What's up?
Sorry.
What's up?
Where'd they put the mines at?
I have no idea.
Ooh. Wait, is it one live?
For Germans.
Thank you. Sorry about that. Just got Judge and Judd.
Hold more.
Why'd you give up?
Well, you guys. Yeah, you did, didn't you?
My bad.
I'm just spraying into one.
Yeah! Oh, damn! You son of a bitch. Oh! Oh,
shit! Sneaky.
Northwest, right in the bush line. They're close.
Don't give up,
well.
Judge.
Put a lot of grenade to that bush.
Uh-oh, dinner's coming.
Hopefully. Hey, watch, did I hear movement on just outside of our bunk?
Oh, shit!
Oofed.
My bad.
Ooh.
Do you watch that happen?
Yep.
It's like, I don't have a morphine, you're gonna have to respawn.
If the Germans eradicate everybody, which within the defense point, they win. Then we'll stop and do the last one.
That's it.
That's it.
Nice.
Nice. All
right, I'll announce the ceasefire.
Ceasefire. Yep.
Great fucking job, Allies. I mean, you guys held your ground really good. So good job with that. Yeah.
Whoever was on the 30, good MG work.
Yep. Right when we went live, you put the fucking pressure right on there. Hell yeah, and buddy. Honestly, they were like, they were like, holy shit. All right, yeah. Americans, stay at the base. Germans, feel free to go wherever you want to go for this last round. So, Ethan, what you're going to do, you're going to set up your fire teams like everyone else has, however you want, and you're going to take one fire team, you're going to keep them at the defense point, and then you're going to take another fire team, and they're going to be your satellite squad. This is called the reach around. So what you're going to do is they are going to go hunting for the advancing enemy force. Okay? Does that make sense?
Yep.
Hell yeah. It's all yours. Oh no. One. Oh, you bastard.
Sorry, this is not gonna be clean.
No.
Oh my god.
Hey, please, no mortars directly on the point, please.
Copy that.
Thank you. Oh. Damn. Gotta get in there, boys. Alright, push guys, push, get in there. Top all back into one channel one last time.
Nice retake, guys.
Fucking great job.
That was awesome.
That was really
fucking
good.
You guys take my hay bale.
Did you see me kill like four or five of them inside the fucking point my Browning?
Yeah, I saw you kill one of them, Cake. Nice. Yeah, who was trying to get Juan in the barn? I was watching that
many
little firefight. Many people.
I did. It was just like one, two, three. Four. Oh, hey, another one, and I'm dead. I wasn't expecting any more.
I was like hit-firing at the barn because, like, oh, I couldn't aim. And then you're pitting me like, shit.
I did not know you could get a second for real water.
Great job, everyone. Instructors, thanks for giving up the hard way. Very
yep,
good job.
No problem.
Very good job. Yeah, I hope everyone enjoyed this training. I know I said we were going to do a live match at the end, but honestly, I think this is as far as we should take it.
I think that was about as good
yeah.
as it gets.
He was a famous trumpet man from old Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowin' reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy.